Well, to shed more light, we are back with Dr. Adel Al-Ghandour, agriculture expert. Good afternoon, sir.
Hello, how are you?
Hello, sir.
Yes, I am.
Yes, Dr. Ghandour, Egypt and Egyptian vegetables and fruits are distinguished by their high quality and also with its great taste. So where are these products located on the international classification?
Actually, the agriculture product for fruit and vegetables from Egypt is very, very distinguished. Especially for orange, we are one of the first exporters of orange, Valencia orange, as well now as grapes and other fruit trees. And now we are coming for exporting date palm, especially for the high quality cultivars that have been introduced to Egypt, like Magdoul and Barhi. And now we open a very new market in China and in different countries. And I think the future will be very good for this date palm. Initially,
yes.
We expected to increase our export by 2.5 billion US dollars from just because we have project to cultivate 5 million date palm from Magdoul, as well equal to that Barhi. But with Magdoul, we can really now cultivate half of this amount, about 2.5 million trees up to now.
Yes, Dr. Ghandour, could you name some of the distinguished or unique fruits that Egypt produces?
Yes, we are producing, actually our main activity now for oranges,
yes,
and for the second crop actually will be grape. We have also potato,
yes,
and onion. Also, we are a very big exporter, as well as green bean also. Also, strawberry, either as fresh fruit or frozen, or also juices. So we are exporting a lot of agriculture products, either fresh or frozen, or as juice.
Yes.
Also, pomegranate, we are exporting. Also, date palm, as I mentioned before.
Yes, so Dr. Ghandour, what makes the Egyptian products from the fruits and the vegetables very unique?
Yes, actually, our production now on the international standard. Most of our farms getting what we call it GAP, good agricultural practices, and also we make analysis for pesticide residue, and also we produce some fruits under organic label, so it is very very safe to use, especially for Europe and other countries. Also, we are extended our market for exportation to Arab countries, like all Gulf countries, Saudi Arabia, and all Gulf countries, as well now the new market coming is Africa, especially after I think we shall have a very big increase in our export to Africa after opening at the end of this year of the road Alexandria Cape Town, because it will help for sure for increase our exports for our products to African countries. That most of the crop we cultivate didn't succeed under these conditions.
Yes, yes, Dr. Dr. Ghandour, also, how can Egypt export more crops as, to Europe and Australia and I mean to the whole world?
Actually, all the NGOs and the government help all to try to increase our export. First, there is international exhibitions for fruit, like there is a very big exhibition in Berlin, as well as in China, in Italy, in France. So we must be show our product and meet our the people who import fruit and vegetables, so we do that. As well as we have to make some markets, especially for some crops that have not established markets like date palm. And we suggest that this will help for increase our export from date palm, that we are increasing the area of it in Egypt, mainly for export.
Yes,
and also there is a lot of new crops coming as new crops like dragon fruit and some other non-traditional fruit, and I think it will help.
Yes.
Also, now there is a new trend to growing through hydroculture, and especially for leaf crops like herbs and lettuce. And this, I think, will make a very big export. Also, we are exporting herbs. It is a very important crop in five governing regions, in Fayoum, in Giza, in East Wave, and in Minya and Asyut.
Yes.
And also it achieved a very good result, either as dried herbs or as fresh herbs.
Yes. So, Dr. Ghandour, also, what are the characteristics of the crops in Egypt and the kind of the soil and the plenty of water that Egypt have?
Egypt, actually, you know, Egypt, we don't have too much water because we depend basically on the Nile and we have a limited resource.
Yes.
We cultivate only 4% of our land. And the reason is the limiting of water.
So Dr. Yes. Dr. Ghandour, also Egypt is the land of civilization, and the Egyptian civilization mainly dependent long ago on agriculture. So
yes.
From this culture, could you give us your insight concerning this?
Actually, our civilization, because we are depending on the Nile for cultivation. So if we didn't cultivate, we can't live. And this is opposite to the tropical places. Tropical, they have rains, the plant coming without any effort. But Egyptian, we have the oldest farmers in the world, because if we didn't cultivate, we can't live. So it is a very old job for the Egyptian to be growers.
Yes.
So we get actually, and most of the African coming asking for how to develop their agriculture, because still their agriculture very primitive rain fed area, and the productivity is very low. But we, with our limited water, we secure a very high yield, and with very good quality, and our weather also help us to give a very quality fruits. The difference between temperature day and night is create, and also that we have always sun. This actually make a very tasty crop.
Yes, Dr. Ghandour, recently the state is, or the political leadership is keen on establishing agricultural, mega agricultural projects. So could you give us your point of view concerning this?
Yes, yeah, sure. Our political leader, Sisi, have a very important project to cultivate the 5 million date palm trees started in Upper Egypt, especially in Tushka, as well as he encouraged the private sector to cultivate a huge amount, and this will increase, it will double our export. Also, now the mega project for the Daba corridor, and it will actually, he cultivate a lot of land and cultivated with exportable crops like potato, peanut, and some very important crops. So this will really significantly will affect our export of agricultural products.
Yes. Yes, I thank you very much for your time. Also, thank you for your valuable information, Dr. Adel Al Ghandour, agriculture expert. Thank you very much for joining us over the phone. Well, with this, my dear viewers, we come to the end of this episode of our program, Cairo Local Time. My name is Amal Mukhtar. Thank you for watching.